Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is me, Simran. So today in this video, I'm going to be talking about a very interesting topic which is rather highly in demand in the industry. The topic is about machine learning, how to bring it your machine learning models or your deep learning models to production. The topic I'm going to talk about is about model deployments. So firstly, before starting into model deployments, I would like to explain you about a very important term, which is full stack data science and MLOps. What is the difference between these two terms? And because it is gaining a lot of momentum in the industry, so what is it that as a beginner you have to be aware of in order to get started as a very a very good MLOps engineer or say a full stack data scientist? What are the key terms and the aspects you should be aware of? So I have divided this video basically into four parts. Today is going to be this video particularly is going to be the introductory video where I'm going to be explaining you about all the terms that you should be familiar with about full stack data science and MLOps. And then later it's mostly about model deployment that I have covered. So in the next few videos, which is the part 2, 3, and 4, I'm going to deal about the model deployments where I'm going to show you practically as to how you can deploy your machine learning model firstly into your local environment and then finally host it publicly as well. So, you know, and what are the different tech stacks and the terminologies you'll be coming across. So basically, let's just get started. So basically, I've written a blog over here which talks about MLOps. And, it actually also gives you an idea into how you could get started as a full stack data scientist and what is a full stack data scientist. So basically, if you compare, if you talk about data science or you compare that with full stack data science, the term over here is full stack. So as it, as the word over here, it says data science is mostly about, it's about analyzing the data and driving business decisions by, generating useful insights or key insights from your data analysis. That is the work of a data scientist. But what do you think would be the work of a data engineer? Because in a data science team, you have different departments. We have data engineer, we have something, someone who works as a data scientist and a data analyst, although all of them work in the same team, but then there is differences in the kind of work they do. Data engineering is mostly about building and managing databases. They mostly handle the data, not only the data cleaning, but also the organizing, the managing of the data, and also the building of the databases, the data lakes. And wherever you are actually extracting data, raw data from various sources, the data engineer is the one who have to actually convert that raw data into a usable format and then send it across the correct format to the data analyst and the data scientist to further carry on the process of, be it data analysis, generating insights, making ML predictions, and then the ML engineer. So they all work in collaboration. So basically, if you talk about full stack data science, full stack data scientist is someone who actually, is working on an end-to-end data science project, I would say. So basically, you can look into this particular diagram, which clearly explains the life cycle of any data science project. A data science project, it starts with first with the problem identification. Now, when we say problem identification, it is mostly about the business problem, because any, a data scientist firstly has to solve a business problem thoroughly. So a full stack data scientist has to be working on a end-to-end data science project. See, when I say end-to-end, it's not only that you are working on a data science project in your local environment. You should be familiar with the something called a very important term called as model deployment. So the this particular video is dedicated to introducing to you the terms about model deployment and such things in data science, full stack data science and MLOps. But in the following videos, I'll be talking specifically about model deployment, because that is the most important part of any machine learning or a data science project to actually make it usable as a prototype. So we talk about model, problem identification. Next comes the data collection, where you are going to, or the data science team is going to collect and collect some data, and data acquisition is going to be done. Later it's going to data pre-processing is the next stage of it. Next we have exploratory data analysis, followed by model training, prediction using ML algorithms, followed by deployment, and finally there is another important term, which is monitor and operationalize. Now this is a particular cycle. So you can see the, if you've heard of software development life cycle, it's an iterative cycle of all the processes we have. So, we can compare that to this particular, you know, full stack domain over here, full stack data science project. It's also an iterative cycle. So basically, when you are working as a team of in a data science project, it's not that you don't have to know software engineering practices. You should be aware of some certain software engineering methodologies, be it agile frameworks, agile methodologies, and so on, so that those practices can be, you know, effectively be implemented. And also, programming knowledge is a must in data science projects. So I would also highly recommend that, along with research methodologies, you should have a good, you know, knowledge of programming. Now, programming, when it comes to data science, I would say recommend you Python, Java, R, Scala. These are some of the most prominent programming languages for data science projects. I hope I've given you an insight into what is the life cycle all about for data science projects. So we're going to specifically, you know, I'm pretty sure you must be aware of data collection. Then we're going to pre-process the data, which is about cleaning the data. Next, we're going to analyze the data. When I say exploratory data analysis, it's all about, you know, understanding the various or analyzing the various features in the data, how, you know, the different attributes present in your data set before actually training your machine learning model. Now, till here, that is still exploratory data analysis is the part of data analysis. Data pre-processing, cleaning, you know, managing data, extract, transform, load, which is, you know, extracting data from various data sources, converting into the raw data into a particular usable format, or basically storing it in a data lake or a data warehouse. That is the work of a data engineer. And then coming to model training is the work of a data scientist and a machine learning engineer, who's actually the work is to build the machine learning model on the data, on the clean data. And even after you build the machine learning model, there is a lot of improvement and monitoring which has to be done. You cannot just build any model but leave it, but you have to also you know, keep on monitoring the performance of the model and improve the performance. So there are different metrics of evaluation. So in my if you refer to my video on overfitting, underfitting, and I've talked about bias, variance, trade-off, that I have explained you in any machine learning model what are the scenarios you come across. So that will be a very perfect video for you to watch. That is in the playlist of data science as well. You can have a look. Then we have prediction using ML algorithms, finally deployment and monitor and operationalize. So this is the life cycle of a data science project. Now, if I talk about, you know, I also, this is a flowchart representation of that. So basically, you know, what is this deployment word I'm talking about? That is most important in MLOps and full stack data science. Deployment is basically your you know, taking your machine learning model to production. That is deployment. So you need to know certain frameworks, certain technologies in order to do that. You cannot just, you know, deploy your application. You need some, you know, some frameworks which are containerization tools. Basically, if you heard of Docker, you need to basically containerize your application, your machine learning application or data science project, all the code and the dependencies into an isolated container, and then you can deploy it easily into a production environment. You could do that. You could ship your models basically. So if you've heard of the term DevOps, which stand, you know, which makes it very easy or automates the process of deployment. That's why I've raised a poll in my playlist in my community section where I talked about MLOps. So MLOps is basically, yes, it is machine learning operations. It is a combination of machine learning and DevOps. So basically, you need to know an understanding of software engineering practices, DevOps as well, in order to learn what is MLOps, because MLOps is also dealing with models at the production environment. So that is all about deployment. Now, coming to what I was talking about, end-to-end application, and why is full stack data science more concentrated on this particular term, which is end-to-end application. End-to-end application is nothing but, you know, all the process of data science, which starts right from the data collection and then followed by data pre-processing, then, you know, data analysis, exploratory data analysis. You know, before that, you have to also do feature engineering. That is very important, or feature selection, basically, to understand or to select the most important features or the, you know, attributes which are going to actually determine the predictions for us. So that is feature selection, and then feature engineering. Then we go to model training and model evaluation. Finally, after we have tested the model on our test data set, we again, you know, we just don't deploy it. We have to again experiment. You know, there's a term called experiment tracking, which is again a part of MLOps. So experimentation tracking, or you also have to monitor the performance of your model by performing model evaluation, by selecting the right features in the right model. Then you have deployment to the production, firstly to your local environment, and then if everything goes right, you send it to production. But be careful, because there are certain issues that you should be familiar with before sending your models to production. So later as well, you have to keep monitoring your model and operationalizing it. That's the entire end-to-end application I was talking about. So when I talk about end-to-end application, you know, any application has the front-end and the back-end. Front-end is what the user sees, and the back-end is the server logic, basically, we could say, or what operations is going to be done, the coding part. So this is just a generic flowchart, okay? So this does not apply for all the use cases, but you can take it off like some framework examples I've given here. Suppose if you're using Fast API, Streamlit, Gradio, these are basically for, you know, these have their own user interface or the GUI setup. And they are very beginner friendly, so I would highly recommend you to, you know, have a look into the Streamlit, Gradio, Fast API, and also you have something called as Flask, which I'll be talking in the later videos of this tutorial. So that is also going to be the front end, one of the front end frameworks, a web framework basically for deployment. So basically, you have in Fast API, you have the Swagger UI and the REST API. I've talked about APIs exclusively in my videos, so do refer that in the previous videos. So basically, after you have Fast API and you've set up in locally the Swagger UI and REST API, basically the API has to be Dockerized. Now you have to Dockerize your application, be it a Flask or a Fast API application, you have to Dockerize it. Dockerizing is basically you're going to deploy it on Docker as a Docker container. Then after Dockerizing your application, you're going to host it on the web. Now for hosting, you can use various cloud providers that are available, example being Heroku. You can also, I'm going to show it to you with Microsoft Azure because that's a very prominent cloud provider. You can also go ahead with Heroku, you can go with Linode, GCP, Google Cloud Platform, and you can also try out AWS, which is Amazon Web Services. So these are very prominent cloud providers, which can actually help you in deploying. Not only for deploying, they also have their various services, cognitive services in case of Azure, you can actually make or build your own end-to-end applications right from data preparation, collection, and then all the processes are automated. If you've heard of the term AutoML, which actually automates the entire machine learning workflow. So that is all about it. Now coming to Streamlit, Gradio, they have their own cloud. You can actually deploy that on the cloud as well. Streamlit has Streamlit Cloud. So you can do that via APIs. Then backend, you have, I'm using VS Code environment. I'll be showing that. You can use any backend. You can use your own IDE basically. Backend is basically for integrated development environment, which is basically you're doing the coding or the logic part. So you can go with, you know, VS Code. I'm going to use that because that's the most preferred one. Or on the cloud, we have Google Collab. That's, Google Collab IDE, which is on the cloud. So you can also go ahead with that. Otherwise, you could go ahead with PyCharm or any IDE of your choice. Then for this, we have to be aware of certain Python libraries and be it any library. You know, if you're talking about NLP, machine learning, deep learning, the different Python libraries. So that's all about this, what I meant with end-to-end application. So basically, my use case is going to be the SMS spam detection using machine learning. I'm going to talk about model deployment, and it's going to be the 3-part video in the upcoming, just after this video. The consecutive videos will be in this order, but for this specifically, for this video I've designed, is basically I'm going to talk about, you know, how you would get started with MLOps and excel in your full stack data science career and what are the key terms you should be aware of. This is very important because once you understand this, then you will understand why it's actually important to bring your model to production. Because see, in any business team or in any industry, you need to actually make your project usable in some way. So you have to make it in such a way that it can actually be used by the other users as well. So that's all about, you know, full stack data science, and there are various aspects that you should be aware of. So in full stack, basically talking about full stack data science and MLOps, if you talk about MLOps, so MLOps is basically machine learning operations. It's the practice of managing. This is, by the way, a blog I have written on Hashnote. So you can check out. I'll drop the link of this particular blog I wrote in the description section. So you can have a look. Basically, MLOps is machine learning operations. So it's the practice of managing and automating the deployment, monitoring, and maintenance of machine learning models in production environments. So full stack data. So basically, you know, when I talk in production environments, so that is where you're talking about model deployment, monitoring, and maintenance of machine learning models. But when you talk about what is full stack data science, it's more a broad term. So MLOps, I would say, is a subset of full stack data science, because full stack data science is basically it's handling all the data science projects, right from data collection, modeling, analysis, and deployment. So if you talk about how to get started with full stack data science, my strong tips or advice to you is to first get started with a programming language. For learning programming language, I would advise Python or R, because they are very useful, especially for machine learning. And Python itself has a lot of inbuilt libraries. So you can start learning Python. R is for statistical programming language. So especially for visualizing data, it is very handy. Then build a strong foundation. Mathematics and statistics is something which goes without saying, because data science, full stack data science, also involves a lot of analysis, machine learning frameworks, and models. So behind that, you need to know the math behind it. Then comes skills in data processing and cleaning, which is very important, because 80% of the work of a data scientist, or even a full stack data scientist, will actually goes in cleaning the data. That is really something which we do not have to which we actually underestimate, but I strongly suggest you to improve data processing and cleaning skills. You have to deal with real world data. It's like the data is not clean at all. So you have to work on the data pre-processing and cleaning. Then understanding data visualization techniques. So there are different libraries in Python as well, like Matplotlib, Seaborn. So it can actually help in data visualization. Then study machine learning algorithms and techniques. So there are a number of deep learning, machine learning techniques, frameworks, and algorithms that you should be aware of. Like when I talk about in algorithms, there are different algorithms. Like in machine learning, we have three types: supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. So you have to be aware of what algorithm to choose. Is the problem firstly a regression problem? Is it a prediction problem? Or what kind of variables are used? Are the features the continuous variables, or is it discrete variables? After you understand the statistics, then you will get to know which machine learning model to go. Is it a classification problem? If yes, a classification problem, under classification, which model to go with? Do we have to go with logistic regression, or do we have to go with SVM or naive Bayes? So that will actually come to you where with firstly with domain knowledge, with practice, and also you have to identify all these things. And there are different auto ML tools as well which speed up this process of model selection and evaluation. Then learn about big data tools and frameworks is very important. Then gain knowledge in deploying machine learning models. This is very, the core part of any, when I talk about full stack data science, we all know about the data science process, the coding in data science, how to actually clean the data, prepare it, analyze it. This is a core, very important part of data science, no doubt. But then you have to also be aware of model deployment, which is becoming very important. So do learn after you are thorough with that, step by step, go step by step, and then come to model deployment. After that, develop expertise in MLOps practices. Now, MLOps, for learning MLOps, there are certain resources I've attached in this blog itself. So you can have a look into that. And also some MLOps, very really good MLOps platforms are there. You can take a look into weights and biases platform, MLflow. So basically these platforms are for MLOps itself. So they help you in experiment tracking, or basically CI/CD, which is continuous integration and continuous deployment of your model, automating your ML workflow. Then there are several factors that you have to look into, the monitoring of the performance, and also data visualization. Basically for you need to monitor or gain insights from your data. So weights and biases itself has this particular platform for you, where you can actually visualize your data as dashboards. So your entire model can, the performance of that can, you can build dashboards and also collaborate by sharing that dashboard with your team members. So those are all the practices that you should be aware of. Then work on real world projects to gain experience. See, projects is something that will definitely give you exposure to a lot of things. So do that. Stay updated with the latest trends and advancements in data science. Now, 5 ways to boost your full stack data science skills. I've already covered with full work on hands-on projects, understanding business problem behind a use case, strong analysis, visualizations, storytelling abilities, then good understanding of MLOps practices, which is model versioning and data versioning. This is very important. Now see, data set keeps on changing. You can also version your data set. When I say versioning, if you heard about version control system in Git, especially you're managing different software projects, or even you're pushing your code repository from your local to your remote repository on GitHub, then you'll be aware of version control tools, right? So you have something called as versioning there. So basically version are different, when you are changing the version of your software or your project, or be it over here in ML, you have model versioning and data versioning. There is different, you can assign different tags or versions to your model. So the one can be the updated version, the previous one can be the old versions of your model. So whichever model versioning, or basically you're monitoring the versions of the models of the data set, whichever is working well, you can go ahead with that. And the analytics can be actually generated in MLOps platforms. So be aware of that. API integration is again very important. API stands for Application Programming Interface. I was talking about that in my software development video. So you can have a look into that. What is API? How to integrate that? So integration is basically, you know, calling API endpoints. So we can actually define API endpoints in your code and call the respective API. So there are different application programming interface, right? You have OpenAI, that is itself is an API, or you can use OpenAI API when you're actually, you know, working on generative AI projects, or you have different APIs like there are different platforms. So when you're working with, suppose you're working with MLOps platform like WantDB, which is weights and biases, over there itself you'll be having an API. So you need to make calls for API integration. Also be aware of experiment tracking system. Then these are some of the open source resources for learning MLOps, which is this particular link I've attached here, weights and biases platform and so on. And you can also have different, insights into the various blogs. You can follow different tutorials on the net to be aware of what is exactly MLOps and to get deeper into that. So practice programming, coding, and cloud computing concepts as well. This is very important because cloud computing knowledge will actually help you in model deployment to production level. Now, that was all about it from MLOps and full stack data science. So in the upcoming video, I'm going to be actually delving into SMS spam detection using machine learning model deployment, which will be divided into three parts, which is ML model deployed as a Flask web application. Then I'll be showing you how to do the Docker deployment by deploying the Flask web application. Now see, this is a particular framework I've used, Flask. You can also go ahead with Django, or you can go with similar ones like Streamlit. There are many other frameworks. So if you are taking a particular web framework, it completely depends on your choice of the project. Also depends on whether your project is a high scale project or it's a simple project of yours. But a Flask is definitely very beginner friendly. It's also having a very simple interface, so you can go with Flask. It's a micro web framework. Then I'll be showing you the Docker deployment. Docker is for containerization, so that is a containerization tool. Then I'll be deploying the same on Microsoft Azure cloud provider. So that was all about this model deployment and MLOps video. I hope you have liked it. And if you have really learned something from this video, then do like and share with your friends to spread the knowledge, and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not yet subscribed to it, to stay tuned for further videos and interesting content on computer science topics. And I'll be demonstrating various projects as well, and also be going through various, I'll be also be explaining you different concepts, not only in data science, but in other areas of computer science as well. So like, share, and comment. Thank you.